Hello everyone, welcome again to the next session on French classical menu. Today we are going to discuss potage to poisson, what are the courses are there and how they are served and what are the examples of the dishes which are served in these particular courses. So this is the second video on French classical menu. Previously we have done what are adobes. And what are the various types of adobes, like classical adobes and general adobes, and what are various examples of classical adobes as well as general adobes. So first we'll start with potage, that is the second course of French classical menu. Now potage is a French term for soup. There are two types of soups basically. One is the thick soup and the second one is thin soup. So if we talk about thin soups, they can be classified again into two categories, and the soups which are served without the garnish and the soup which are served with the garnish. And on the other hand, thick soups can be classified into cream soup, puree soup, bisque and chowder. The most important thing to remember about the soup is that they have different cover for the different type of soup. So if we are talking about a thin soup, the cover would be a soup bowl, a B&B plate as an underliner, a doily paper and a dessert spoon. And on the other hand, the cover for thick soup would be a soup plate, underliner, a dinner plate with a doily paper and a soup spoon. So the cover are different for both the soups. So let's see what are thin soups first. So when we serve with the garnish, they are various examples like consommé brunoise, consommé julienne, consommé celestine, consommé florentine, consommé royal, consommé dewberry, and most of the time they are named after the garnish. So when a consommé is basically a clear soup, okay, which has been passed. So the consommés are named after the garnish. So whatever garnish they have, they are named after that. Cover for consommé soup is double handled consommé cup or a soup bowl. If you do not have that, then a doily paper, underliner, quarter plate and a soup spoon. And when the consommés are served without garnish, the examples are consommé clair, consommé en tasse, consommé en jelly. Okay, and the difference in the cover is that instead of soup spoon, a dessert spoon is to be used because there are no garnishes, so we do not require a bigger spoon to have the soup. So that's why a dessert spoon is to be used in the cover of consommé without garnish. Most important thing about soup is that bread is a natural accompaniment to all the continental soups. So whatever soups you are serving, you can serve various types of breads like toast, cheese sticks, bread sticks, garlic rolls, bread rolls, okay, and various other types of breads. Bread is always served before the soup in a bread basket or on a side plate. So in the images you can see in the left you have a consommé brunoise soup and on the other side you have a consommé without garnish. So that's how these soups are served. Next course that we have after potage is œuf. œuf means eggs. Eggs can be served in various varieties, like now they can be poached egg or a scrambled egg or any other style of preparation. Some examples are written over here, like omelette espagnole, omelette au tomate, omelette au champignon, omelette fin herbs, and various other examples. So I'll show you some image. On the left you have omelette œuf en cocotte, and on the right you have omelette florentine. So florentine is a French term for spinach, and œuf en cocotte. Cocotte is a type of cup in which it is to be served. Next course we have farinu. Farinu is a course which include various styles of pasta preparation and rice preparations. And the examples are spaghetti napolitane, spaghetti bolognese, ravioli, gnocchi romaine, and cannelloni. These are various types of pastas with accompanied sauce, and they can be served in this particular course. Over here you can see a gnocchi pasta on the right, and on the left you can see a spaghetti napolitane. Napolitane is a red sauce in which this noodle pasta has been cooked. And the next course is poisson. Poisson is a course in which fish preparations are to be served. Various style of fish and various style of fish preparations can be served in this particular course. For example, there could be a poached fish, a fried fish, shellfish can be served. The cover for fish course is fish knife, fish fork, and a fish plate, or also known as half plate. So they can be served in this manner. Some other examples of fish preparations are sole munir, sole colbert, sole cubert, darned saumon grillé, and omard newberg. So I'll show you an image which that on the right side you have omard newberg. Omard is a French term for lobsters, and on the left side you have another fish preparation, grilled fish preparation, which is being served with potatoes and French beans and peas. In the next session we will be talking about the next courses, which are from entree to roti. Thank you.